In this lecture, we will cover toppling, which is very interesting concept. And in this case, what we have done is we have taken a block of mass m, and it is placed on a surface which has static friction coefficient of mu s. And I will write only as mu right now while solving the problem. The weight of this block will act at its center of mass. All the weights act at their center of masses of the body. So it is mg. Is the place where the weight acts. Since it is pushing down the surface, we know in mechanics there is a counter force which is n, and n is equal to mg if it is not moving. If it is not moving vertically, only then n is equal to mg. So it is not moving, so n is equal to mg. Where this n will be? Is it just at this point? Where it will be? Actually, this n can be anywhere. Suppose the n is here at this location, which is at a distance x. I'll explain this, why this x, you will understand the concept of this x. So this is the location of n. Let me assume that this is the location of n. N is not here to begin with. N is at this location. Now, just try to see, for the body to topple, what are the torques which want to topple it? Torques which want to topple is F into H. Force F is being applied horizontally at a height of H. So about this point, if I take the torques, moments, about this point, this is the toppling torque, which is trying to topple it, plus what is the other one? Is Nx. Actually, nature doesn't want it to topple. So X has to be as less as possible, because more the X, more is the likelihood of toppling. But we are right now taking a situation where it is not toppling, it is in equilibrium. So just see, anti-topple. Anti-topple is only mg, which is mg into L upon 2. And right now we are assuming it to be in equilibrium. So F is equal to mu, F is equal to F, friction force. And F is equal to mu mg, because n was equal to mg. These are given kind of thing, very simple. Now it is not toppling, so the moments topple and anti-topple both are equal to each other. So mg, so fh plus nx is equal to mg l upon 2. So what is the value of x? Nx is equal to mg l upon 2 minus fh. N is what? Mg. So value of x is L upon 2 minus F upon mg into h. So it is the combination of various dimensions and forces which are determining the location of x. And x is always less than L upon 2. This x will not be here. See, the expression is telling me if it is not toppling, and you will see at the point of toppling also interesting thing happens. So x is always less than L upon 2. So x is on that side. Now suppose I increase the force. Suppose at this point it is not toppling. The locations are such it is not toppling. I further increase the force. This is x1 and this is f1. It is not toppling. Location of x is such, it is x1. Now I change the force to f2. What is x2? See, L upon 2 minus f1 plus, say, delta F is the force I have increased, h upon mg. So my x2 is L upon 2 minus f1 h upon mg minus delta F h upon mg. So my x2, you can see, has further reduced by this. And the reduction factor is proportional to the force. I keep on increasing the force, and you see, nature is just shifting x towards that side because it doesn't want it to topple. That is why it is shifting. So naturally, if the balance is happening, the normal reaction is shifting towards that side, value of x is reducing. It can reduce up to what point? This x can at the most become zero. You can't reduce x below that. So we keep on increasing, and we reach a point where x is 0. Now we take the moments. Now we have reached a critical point where x has reached 0. Normal reaction is not able to help anymore. This poor fellow cannot go on that side. It cannot go, otherwise he would have gone and helped you. It is not helping you anymore. It has helped you enough and is helping you by going towards that side. It doesn't want it to topple. Now it has reached a point, it is pushed to the wall. It can't go beyond that. Still, I want a situation where it doesn't topple. For it to not to topple, mg into l upon 2, this is anti-toppling, should be still greater than whatever is the force now. Force now, I'm saying. Initial was F1, force now into H. So, till this time, it is not toppling. Moment F now increases, if F now into H becomes greater than MGL upon 2, it will topple. So at the tipping point, first of all, before you reached a toppling point or a tipping point or a critical point, whatever you may call it, normal reaction has to be first pushed to the wall. You go there first. You push it, go there. And then you see the forces. After that, if F now times H is greater than MGL upon 2, it topples. This is the condition for toppling. Now let us now take an example of a block placed on the wedge. That is the generally example taken, and it is interesting in fact. Let this be the wedge making an angle theta. This is a wedge making an angle theta, and let there be a block which is placed here, and it has mass mg downwards. This component will be mg cos theta, we all know it. I am not going into that detail. This component of force along the plane will be mg sin theta. And there is some normal reaction acting somewhere. Is it not? At some x it was acting, as we have seen. This is point A. First of all, anything can happen to the block. It can slip. And it can topple first. It can slip first, it can topple first. So let us first see the condition for slipping, when it will slip. This is normal reaction N, which is equal to mg cos theta, and the friction force F is here. And please recall there, I have not taken any moment because of the friction force, because it is passing through point A. It was passing through point A. So if you see that I have not taken moment because it is zero. I should have mentioned that. Anyway, now F is equal to mu mg cos theta. Now, for it to slip, mg sin theta must be greater than mu mg cos theta. Means tan theta has to exceed mu for it to slip. So this is a condition for slipping. Now suppose it is not slipping, I am talking about toppling now, forget this. Now for toppling to happen, you know, first of all, this poor N will be pushed to the corner, to the wall, and N reaches here. So it doesn't help you anymore. Now for it to topple, when it will topple? When mg sin theta, and say this is H, and this is L. When mg sin theta into h upon 2, mg sin theta into h upon 2 is greater than mg cos theta into l upon 2. This is the anti-topple, this is topple. So when tan theta is greater than l upon h, it topples. So when tan theta is greater than mu, it slips. When tan theta is greater than L upon H, it topples. Now let us see what happens first. Let us take a simple diagram. I don't know whether it is visible. Let me draw it slightly up. Let me take this diagram and let on this axis I show the values of, let this be the magnitude of mu and let this be the magnitude right now of L upon H, and this is mu. And suppose tan theta is having some value here. This is tan theta. So this is measuring the value of tan theta, mu and L upon H, this vertical axis. X is not measuring anything. It is only placing, here I'm placing the mu value, here I'm placing the L upon H value. So till such time tan theta is lower than both, it is, nothing is happening. Now tan theta is just, and the situation was, we have taken a situation where mu is less than L upon H. Suppose this is the situation where mu is less than L upon H and tan theta is now increasing. I just cross this. So moment tan theta is greater than mu, it slips, but here tan theta is less than L upon H, so it doesn't topple. So when mu is less than L upon H, when mu is less than L upon H, it first slips or skid, whatever you may call it. Now take a reverse situation where this is L upon H and this is mu. Means mu is greater than L upon H. This is the second condition, second situation. This is the first situation, this is the second situation. Now when mu is greater than L upon H, I am seeing increasing the value of tan theta. The moment I cross L upon H, what happens? I topple. So I will first topple. So toppling first. So toppling first, if mu is greater than L upon H, you will topple first. And if mu is less than L upon H, you will slip first. So this is just the basics on the toppling and slipping.